TJ Holmes's wife is probably happy he just filed for divorce yesterday. Yet TJ's the one that's pulling the plug, making it official. He might want to did that a few months ago. But anyway, it's alleged he had an affair with his co-anchor, Amy Robach, that started when the two started training together. I mean, what kind of training was it for the marathon? I don't know. But they needed to do physical activity. They did it. They finished the marathon. Okay, I'll move on. TJ Holmes, as we said, filed for divorce from his second wife, Marilee Fiebig, after his alleged affair with his Good Morning America co-host became public. Again, they were outed. Remember the butt grabbing footage that we saw? Okay, Daily Mail. It's reported that Fiebig was, quote, blindsided by the affair. Had no idea this was going on. Look at TJ creeping me behind. I just can't with the photos. I understand it's part of the story. It's not for me to even get into it. Thank you for removing that because I'm disgusted, okay? He's not my man and I'm disgusted by the way he's carried himself here and seems to have be out for himself is what it is. Our source said the two have been separated for several months, but that they were trying to work things out when news of the alleged workplace romance broke in late November. Several workplace romances, if you believe everything's been written. She's devastated, she had no idea, our informant said, adding that the two were just together for TJ's birthday on August 19th. That's from page 6. Here's that cringeworthy quote from Holmes on their 10th wedding anniversary. I'm gonna try to get through it without throwing up. 10 years ago, Marilee Fiebig married me, and despite my best efforts, she remained married to me the past 10 years. That's not hyperbole. I'm not being dramatic. I gave her plenty of reasons, excuses, and opportunities to walk her fine ass out the door. See, and this is what, there's such a lack of authenticity as he writes this post that seemingly, you know, he's trying to spit bars here, okay? He's so cool with his gangster lean. Respect a woman, that would be a lot cooler. TJ, okay? And don't post about me, okay? Is what he needs to be told. Don't post about me if it's gonna come back to haunt me. Because she doesn't seem like a woman who wants to even be part of this, Jeff, but here she is as TJ prances around. According to page 6, their source claims Holmes and Robach started seeing each other in March. There they are with their medals, back to back, while they were training. Well, New York City Marathon, they both left their spouses in August. Did they really? Because she was, remember, Marilee Fiebig was with TJ. His birthday was in August, right? Never could. I had an ex who tried to sit. I took him to therapy. I said, we're going to therapy. And I said, because I'm not going to sit here and argue with you like I don't have the facts. I did a whole Google slide. I produced a Google slide. And I said, well, he can go first. We needed that closure, Jeff. I said, you can let him go first. And indeed, he took the bait. It's not a surprise, like TJ did to Marilee. I said, by the way, I have produced something for when we go to therapy on Thursday. And I just wanna let you know, I have our timeline, our relationship timeline. And I'm gonna have, he said, well, you're always investigating somebody because you do the news. It's not an investigation, this is our history. Shouldn't Marilee Fiebig be just ecstatic this New Year's Eve? I understand they have a child and it's difficult when relationships break up. But shouldn't she be happy that this guy pulled the plug?
There's definitely going to be a time of grieving, and she definitely deserves that because whatever idea she had about her future probably wasn't this. I think we can go out and say that. So yeah, I think she should celebrate a little bit to get rid of a man who, that post you read, that's embarrassing. Like I understand the spirit of it, but he embarrassed her. Like, dude, come on, man. And then, you brought up the pictures earlier with, you know, with the two of them being caught in public butt grabbing and everything like that, which I'm glad that marathon picture was back to back and not front to front. Never mind. So I'm just like his now soon to be ex-wife has gone through enough. So while we should be happy that she's going to rid herself of this very toxic person, yeah, there's going to be some grieving in her life because there was a lot of hopes and dreams set aside for her in that marriage and that relationship, but that's just how those things go. So happy for her, but sad for her at the exact same time.
You know, I don't have a psychology degree. I'm not a doctor, but this reeks of narcissism. In fact, the other day I went, what's that smell? And then I just looked up and I saw it on page six or something. TJ was in Atlanta. There were pictures of him at Hartsfield Jackson. And I said, well, there it is. I thought I smelled something. Okay. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But the way he's conducted himself here, people fall in love. They fall in and out of love. Things happen. But don't you think, Jeff, it's the way you conduct yourself? A daughter, right? A woman who you claim to love and were married and you posted about, don't post about me, okay? You gotta stop posting about me. And this is what you're doing, you're strutting about?
When you found out he was in Atlanta, did you tell your friends to beware of a black?
Oh, I warned everyone. I said, I put out a bolo, I did. And I don't really believe in bolos because they always get black men in trouble who are misidentified. I put out a bolo to all women everywhere. And I made the age really wide. And I said, beware. I don't know if he's staying here, passing through the airport, but he is in our city. And I want you to keep your guard up. Lock your doors. Okay, don't answer the phone. Okay, TJ is in town. And I have not touched Amy Robach, who has her own seemingly rich history. Whatever, people fall in and out of love. Okay, it just seems really dirty the way things are being conducted here. And maybe you could say, who are you sharing to even comment on these people? Oh, I don't know. But I think she should produce a Google slide, Marilee, and give it to him. I said, these Google slides are wonderful because it's not my words, it's your words. I took footage, voicemails, emails, texts, everything's got a timeline. And I produced this Google slide. And then when he would say something, she'd say, well, Sharon, what do you have to say? Google slide, Google slide. I think he has to confront, you know, that there was a show about it. Look at Your Life, I think it was called, Jeff. Shouldn't he confront this?
Well, look, 'tis the season. I wonder if the Ghost of Christmas Past went to go visit him a couple of days ago for Christmas, just to show him who he is. And maybe that's why this result has come about, because a couple ghosts visited him while he was supposed to be sleeping for Christmas. So good job out of them.
I couldn't agree more. Okay. I want you to stay out of my city until you get well, TJ. And maybe he was here first. I don't know. He did work at CNN all those years. We'll leave it at that. They really don't want to keep doing this story with me because I go off the rails. It's personal to me. Whatever.